Hello again, YouTube. Enzo back with another BMW Z3 vlog. Just a quick update on what I've been doing over the last day or so. Obviously, the weather's a lot better now, so I've been inside just to give everything a good clean. And it's not so bad. Just clean the trim, the dashboard, and a few bits and bobs. I have been busy. I've disconnected the interior light switch now, because obviously that was the problem. The rheostat is faulty when I took it apart, and I've stored everything in here, all inside the plastic housing. Well, I'll show you now if you can see it. I don't know if you can tell, but that little bit down the top there, so obviously something's melted in there, a bit of scoring, so I'm not 100% sure what's happened there, but I bet you that's the problem that's shorted up the lights. So I've just been onto my supplier, BMW trainer, and they have, I've bought one now. It's £103, unfortunately. I was hoping, I did find a few cheaper ones on eBay, but how long are they going to work? So I thought I'll play it safe and get a brand new one. At least I know then it's under guarantee. If something goes wrong, I can take it back and I can get it done. So that will be arriving on Saturday, and I've also booked a car in to have the calipers adjusted. They're gripping too tightly, because I was driving the car this morning. I went to get some petrol, so we've got, not bad, we've got just under half a tank, which is nice. And took it for a good spin for the first couple of miles, not a problem, but then the faster you go, the hotter the brakes were getting, and I could feel the steering wheel juddering, just pulling left, it was pulling right. So that needs to be done, but I knew that when I bought the car anyway, so fingers crossed now. Chris, good man, he will sort me out with either new calipers or refurbished ones, or he might be able to fix them. So far inside is good. I've also had a good think about what I'm going to do with the car. I've decided I'm not going to change anything inside. I was going to maybe change the dials, get them out and put some LEDs there. I'm not going to go down that road, because I probably will want to sell this car at some point, and a lot of people look for is originality, so I'm keeping it. I'm not even going to repair the rip on the driver's seat. I'm going to keep it totally original. One thing I will do, I will probably replace the gator. I will replace this and this, maybe have it chromed or something, chromed or black, and replace the gator, have a red gator, and here as well, to match the seats and the leather. And I was possibly thinking of having this, the bar for the roof, I was possibly having that painted red as well, because you can see that it's chipping away a little bit now. So I thought so that's an option, I might have it done right now. So nothing much is going to be done inside. I'm still going to keep the radio, because it's an original radio. It works fine. Tape deck was fine, and I got a CD change in the boot, so I'm perfectly happy with that. That can stay. So everything else is in really good condition. So nothing inside is going to be done apart from a new light switch. So there we go. Couple of mods exterior. First thing I'm going to be doing is I'll be buying a K&N air filter to upgrade the air box a bit, so the car can breathe a bit better. And I will also be buying a strut bar, like I did on the E46 as well. So those are the only engine mods I'm going to be doing. I'm tempted to take it for a carbon clean, but I'm not 100% sure, so I'll just leave it there for the time being. Definitely going to replace the front headlights, because they're a little bit dirty and manky, so I'm going to see if I can get a nice upgrade, like halo, angel eyes or halos, whatever they're called. I'm going to get a nice set of those if possible, maybe even get a new front bumper for it as well. So I don't know about the rear lights, I might leave the rear lights alone. Hood is pretty good, it's the original hood. You can see it's nice and taut with a little flexibility in it, really good. So I don't think I'll bother with that for the time being. And you know, if it starts to leak over time, then yes, I will change it. But it's the original hood, I'm going to leave it. Quick question, if anybody knows what's the best thing to treat this with, please let me know, because it's looking a bit... Right, let's have a look. Let's get out. You can see, you know, it's a little bit dirty in places, because the gentleman has said, like, he's put wax, he's just threw lots of wax on it. So if anybody knows what I can use to treat this hood with, just to maybe make it a little bit blacker, or to help it keep it, you know, waterproof, things like that, then please let me know. There we go. Oh, screwdriver, I'm going to need you. So, yeah, excited. So obviously we've got a bank holiday weekend coming up now, bank holiday Monday. So that part now will be collected on Saturday, and then I'll take it down to my mate Chris and he'll do the brakes, and hopefully I'll ask him to do that at the same time. I've dismantled it as much as I can. There's not really a lot on the forums about it, and one website I had to pay to get access to all the things. So I've done what I can. Apparently, I don't know if I can show you now, but right down in here now, where my fingers are, that little bit there now, see if I can zoom in nice and tighter. Yeah, that little bit there now where it's a bit scuffed there, apparently on the two sides, and if you can see in the holes there, there's a special key to fit in there, and then you push the barrel in then, so that comes out first, and then all this assembly comes out. So it's a bit cumbersome. I've even had all these panels off now, and I've been in there, been fiddling. I thought, I'm not going to go any further because I really don't want to break the car. I really don't know, because as you can see in the top, you know, what I've been trying to bend it, I've actually buckled it now. So it's a good thing I'm having a new one anyway. But apart from that, I did enjoy it this afternoon. I did take it for a good spin, which I enjoyed. Sorry, bit out of focus there. I wonder what's happening with the camera. There we go. Yeah, I did take it for a limited spin because I went to get fuel, and I did enjoy it. Haven't taken it for a spin with the top down yet, because obviously with the calipers the way they are, I really want to enjoy it, but not yet, not until everything has been done. So fingers crossed now, I'll probably come back with another vlog on possibly Tuesday, Wednesday, something like that. Hopefully Chris would have done the car, I would have had it back, and we could take it for a spin, and then I'll take it somewhere nice and quiet. It's a bit busy at the moment, but I'll take it somewhere nice and quiet, and I'll do a full video review. We'll go through absolutely everything together. So I'm going to continue cleaning and tidying and hoovering and doing little jobs, bits and bobs. Not able to buy it this month, obviously, because I've got the wife went nuts because I bought this for 900 quid and was supposed to be going on holiday in about 16 days time, so she wasn't happy with that. So I'm going to leave it for this month now, so I'll probably have to wait till the end of May till I get my next wage, and then get a strut bar, get a cane and air filter, what else, and then some headlights as well. And then fingers crossed then, because I'm going to try and do subtle improvements. Not too much. I'm not going to spend a lot of money, but just a couple improvements. And then I know then when I do come to sell the car, regrettably, because I have bought it to sell to make a profit on. And fingers crossed then, whoever buys the car then will have an absolutely mint Z3. So I don't ship to America. If you want it, you're gonna have to pay that yourself. But obviously, I'll give my YouTubers the first chance, but yeah, it's a very, very nice car. It is, it's lovely, absolutely lovely. I've just fallen for this head over heels. I really have fallen for it. It's a pucker car. So there we go, thank you very much. Diolch yn fawr, please comment, rate and subscribe. More Z3 vlogs will be coming over the next couple of days. So let's get this headlight unit working, let's get the brakes working, and then I shall do a full video review, and we'll go for a damn good spin with the top down. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah, I thought you'd enjoy that. So again, thank you very much. Please comment, rate and subscribe, and I will see you very soon. Thank you. Ta-ra.